Oh yeah, I'm about to drop some particle physics in the club. The LHC is super duper fly, you know what I'm saying. Check it.
27 kilometers tunnel underground, designed with mind to send protons around. A circle that crosses through Switzerland and France. 60 nations contribute to scientific advance. Two beams of protons swing round through the ring they ride, tilling the hearts of the detectors that made it collide. And all the energy packed in such a tiny bit of room becomes mass particles created from the vacuum. And then,
oh yeah,
LHCBs is where the antimatter's gone. Alice looks at collisions of lead ions. Stainless and Atlas are two of a kind. They're looking for whatever new particles they can find. The LHC accelerates the protons in the lead, and the things that it discovers will rock you in the head. We see asteroids and planets, stars galore. We know a black hole resides at each galaxy's core. But even all that matter cannot explain what holds all these stars together. Something else remains. The star matter interacts only through gravity. And how do you catch a particle? There's no way to see. Take it back to conservation of energy, and the particles appear clear as can be. You see particles flying in jets they spray, but you notice there ain't nothing going the other way. You say my law has just been violated, that don't make sense. There's gotta be another particle to make this balance. And it might be dark matter, and for the first time we catch a glimpse of what was from most of the known verse. Because LHCBs is where the antimatter's gone. LHCBs thinks the collisions of red ions. Cause when it meets its normal twin, they both annihilate. Matter turns to energy and then it dissipates. When matter is created from energy, which is exactly what they'll do in the LHC, you get matter and antimatter in equal parts. And they try to take this back to when the universe starts, the Big Bang, back when all the matter exploded. But the amount of antimatter was somehow eroded, because when we look around we see that matter abounds, but the antimatter's nowhere to be found. That's why
to the E to the R.